Okay, recording is starting, and let's see. This is our lecture. Okay, we come over here, and again we come to the chapter 13. Chapter 13 supposed to be the problem number 5 of our final examination. We are talking about the column. Okay, we are talking about the column, and again.Column can be classified into what's so called the short column, and another one is the long column. For the short column, under the application of the compression, the failure, okay, of the short column is maybe due to the clutching.If it's the concrete of concrete, okay, and it's maybe due to the cracking of what of cast iron, or it's maybe the yielding of steel. It depends on type of material, okay, and these we call them material failureOkay, when the stresses, maximum stresses in the short column is larger than or equal to, for example, the yielding of the steel. However, for the buckling, it occurs in the long column under the compression. You just take your ruler and push it. Okay, this kind of buckling.Is a kind of stability failure, which is the failure of the structure. It's not the failure of the material. This is the failure of the material. Okay, and you may see under the stability failure, the stress is less than the sigma sub y. Why?When you push this one curve, when you take the force out, it's go back. It's linear, elastic behavior. The material did not fail, but structural is fail. Okay, the structure is fail. Okay, and by doing this, this is the very basic thing about the buckling of the column that I going to tell you.And then we come to Professor Euler. Like 200 something years ago, Professor Euler working on the problem of this. And he do some mathematic derivation. And he found that under the compression, there is the force that is called P critical, or in short,we call it critical load. That's produce the column, which is one is pin, another one is roller to buckle under the critical load. And he said P critical for this kind of simple column can be determined.From this equation, pi square, you know pi, right? 3.1416, modulus of elasticity, times the moment of inertia, okay? And divided by the length square. So what he said, this one is another kind of equation.That we use to predict the stability failure of this column. Anyway, the buckling column in general, when you push it like this, it's got one curve. Anyway, when you put it like this, you do the bracing. This one at the middle of the column, we call bracing. You will get this kind of curve. Okay, so in general, he said,This is going to be a factor in front of this equation n square. So if this column
under my compression have the critical load of 10 kilonewton, and then I just change it, I place it at the middle, this one going to take the critical load of 2 square. This is going to be 4 times larger than this one.
And I have some example to show you about the sanitary water tank in which the column is really high, the tall tower, and we do the bracing for the column to increase the critical load of that column. And also, after for a while, some people may say we can call the critical load as the Euler load. Okay, if you guys are going to derive some important equation in the future, the people may be setting up Sithichai equation, those kind of things. Anyway, that is going to be what we have. Again, the L is the length, okay? The I is going to be the moment of inertia, okay? And the E is going to be the modulus, God bless you, of elasticity, okay? And then we're going to do what? We're going to use that equation to analyze for the critical load of the columns. However, in our real world, the column is not as only the simple column. There is something about the column. For example, if you go to in front of our university, you may see the flagpole, okay? The flagpole actually didn't take the compression, but if you put this kind of force into the flagpole also buckling. But the buckling of the flagpole is not like this one. The buckling of the flagpole going to be something that's going to be something like this. So this equation must be modified, okay? And you not only have the flagpole type of column. If the column is in between the story number 4 and the story number 5 of a tall building, you may say the top of the column can be fixed, the bottom of column can be fixed. What we have, if this one is simple, is going to have this type of deformation, right? But when it's in compression, see the picture. See this one happened. The shape of the column is going to be like this. What happened is the shape change. Okay, this one. And you can expect this one going to have larger critical load. Why? Because the top and the bottom of the column are fixed. Okay. By doing that, you may estimate this one to be deformed in the shape something going to be like this, okay? And also, not only that, we also have another type of column in which the top is the roller, and the bottom is fixed. Under the application of compression, this column will deform in the shape like this one, okay? It's going to be in the combination of the top one and the middle one to be this black one. What happened is, they said, by doing this, we set this point. This point is the point of zero moment. The pin and the roller have zero moment. And if you measure this, this one can extend to be a combination of one curve. And if you measure this, this one going to take the length of 2L. And this one, if you take it, this one going to take the length of only 0.5L, okay? And if you measure, that is a test. I will show you the type of the test and you measure this, this one going to be 0.7L. Okay, engineer said, oh, this can be, if we assume this one is L, this can be 1L, this can be 2L, this can be 0.5L, this is 0.7L. So they just said, if that's the case, we got to modify the length. Okay, so by this case, the length of the column modified to be what's so called the KL, in which we call this one effective length. Okay, effective length. And then, oh, sorry. And then we come to the what and what? The critical stress. After we determine the critical load, okay, another problem will ask you to determine the critical stress. The critical stress is the sigma critical over here. By dividing the P critical by the area of the column, we got the stress, right? Just divide the column by the A. And by putting that, what we have is for a single curve, we're going to have this one for pi square E, okay, I, and divided by A, divided by L square. Why Ajahn putting thing like this? If you thinking about the section of the column, for example, it's going to be like this, okay? You may have this one for the X, and you may have this one for the Y, and you may have I sub X equal to, for example, is this one is going to be B, and this one going to be H, is going to be BH cubed over 12. Okay, and if it's in Y direction, it's going to be H B cubed over 12. So whatever is going to be the I, the moment of inertia is the property, is a property of section. Okay, the I. And A also, the A is going to be BH, the area also a property of the section. So if you put thing like this and you go back into your engineering statistics chapter 10, okay, there is something called the radius of gyration, which is the property of the section. We call this one square root I over A. We just do the dividing of I over A. Okay, we call it the radius of gyration. Therefore, this equation will be pi square E divided by L square and time R square. Okay, this is the property of the section. And then our senior engineer also thinking about this thing. About what? There is a man who the same shape as me, and he tall like this. Okay, and me tall like this. If you compare this guy with me, I am more slender. Okay. The same section. The one is chop, is kind of shorter. Okay. Another one is taller. The taller is more slender. They said, if this the case, we can draw this equation to be pi square E, and then divided what so called the L over R square. And they call this one is slenderness ratio. Okay, that mean what? the more slender the lower critical load. Okay, if you put this thing together, the sigma critical is going to what pi is a constant, 3.1416. E is a constant for a column. For example, it's built by steel, it's going to be the whole steel. We not build the column. Half is reinforced concrete. Another top part is steel. We don't do like that. The our steel going to be run from the top to the bottom. Or if it's reinforced concrete, it's going to be from the top to the bottom. Okay. By doing that, this is constant. This is constant. This is going to be what? The inward proportion with the slenderness ratio. By doing this, if you plot the graph by setting this one is sigma critical and you setting this one as the, sorry, is the slenderness ratio. And if you plot the graph and you will have a lab in the material testing, both the CE and the ME. The CE going to take next trimester. The ME going to take on the third trimester of the third year, the first trimester of the first year. Okay. And then you will get the graph that is look like a curve because it's divided by L over R square. By the square, you got the curve. Okay. If you plot it, you may get the curve something that is going to be very, very close to infinity when this one is zero, right? When the divider very short. Is that possible? No, because when is the short column, the column will fail die, the material failure, the maximum can be only sigma sub y. By this case, we can set if that's going to be our consideration. Okay, oops, sorry, supposed to be here. The column can be classified by using this equation and we separate this one into two portions. One is going to be the short column and another part is going to be the long column. Okay, our main objective for this chapter is for the long column. Okay, the equation will be talking about the critical load or the Euler load. And also we going to talking about the critical stress. Yes. Oh, okay. I didn't put it over here. Yes, because the thing going to be like this. Euler start the job like only find the P critical. Euler said this is simple column pi square EI over L square. And then Professor Euler said if we push the basing, it's going to have something like this. And he used the mathematics proof it. Okay. And in reality, you may see most of the column can be have the N square here. Okay, but I just take the simple column as our simple example to derive this kind of sigma critical. So I will talking about this later, but the modification will not end square. There we have something else in the final part of this, and it's going to be the examination. Very good question it's going to be, but the consideration just start by making this equation simple. Okay. And then we come into this point. And then we come into this point. This is going to be the L over R critical. That's going to use to separate the column into short and long column. Again, we come to the long column. And then we will have, after we have the sigma critical or we have P critical, the P allow the PLR in this one going to be the P critical divided by the factor of safety. If you have P critical of 100 kilonewton and then factor of safety of 2.0, you will get the P allow of 50 kilonewton, something like that. Okay, and the last one, we come to the design. I will not involve with the design of column here. I have the YouTube. You guys can go and check it out because the steel design or the machine design in the future, we're talking about this a lot. Okay, by the meantime, if I have time, I can touch it a little bit. Just the use of equation, but it won't be your examination. Your examination going to be the second learning objective, analyze the column. And then coming into what we have, this is the real thing. This is in the lab by the paper. You can go to the research gate and looking for a paper. There is a column, okay? There is a column in the frame. And then they put the force into the column. After they put the force into the column, when the force reach what so called the P critical, okay, the straight line column curve, okay, this one called the buckling. This is show you the steel column, okay, and then there is another buckling in this column. You can see usually this kind is the column with the a kind of straight line, okay. Is as fixed on the top and fixed on the bottom. Under a large compression, what we have, the column just curved like this. Okay, this one different from this. This one is the let's see, this one going to be the, may assume as the roller. This is the pin. This is called the simple column, but this one is the column. The top is fixed, see, by the floor on the top. This one also fixed. Okay, this is really close to the failure of the building. the guy come over here. Yeah, he is really brave to come over here to check thing out. Okay, this is going to be the fixed column, and then what we have is. This theory, I will come very fast. Buckling is the failure of the long column. Okay, is a kind of stability failure. For the short column, the column fail by yielding, which is the material failure. They are different. Under the force for the long column, the column change the shape from this one to this one. This kind of failure, lateral buckling, lateral deformation, we call this is the buckling. And then we call the load that produce the buckling is the critical load, or you may use this Euler load. The equation for this is going to be P critical, it will be pi square EI over L square, and the critical stress is going to be pi square E divided by stress ratio square. I like you guys to remember this, okay? We don't need to remember the N square, but we got to remember this. And we come to this. When I was about 27 years old, I pursued my PhD and I also work. I start working as the service boys in a restaurant that's got $5 per hour, okay? We just work like a 4 hour and then we can have $20 for the party at the weekend, something like that. And also I work as the teaching assistant, like people. And also I work as the research assistant, okay? On the last year before I graduate, I work for my professor by testing this kind of column. We have many kind of structure, have the L section, has the I section with different kind of length, okay? We push them into the compression machine and we found this one. This buckling is a local buckling. Different from this one, this is the global buckling. We do what? We do the testing to develop the design equation for a company called Creative Protrusion. If you go to the Google and then you type this kind of company, Creative Protrusion, and then manual, okay? And then you go to the section called column. If I correct, it's going to be the chapter 5. The first page of chapter 5 mentioned the University of Texas at Arlington. This experimental results, okay, come from the University of Texas at Arlington. That is me. That is nearly 24 years ago. I got $2,000 a month. Very rich. when I just the TA, I got $800. When I go to the lab, use a lot of manpower. I got 2,000 more. I did a lot of plotting for my ajarn also, for my professor. And then this is a kind of material development, structural development. The material is not steel. The material that I test is called GFRP. If you are in the polymer engineering, this is going to be glass, okay, fiber, reinforces, plastic. This plastic is not a typical plastic. It's the thermosetting plastic. It's not thermoplastic. Plastic separate into two things. One is thermoplastic. It can be softened very quick by heat. Okay. Thermosetting one. Okay. Just change a little bit for the heat. Not much. And then it's produced by the word P. The word P is called protrusion. Protrusion. This is a bad thing. This is protrusion. Okay. Some guy said this kind of process can be shipped with the spacecraft to the moon or to the Mars, and they can use this process to produce structural member over there. Believe it or not, we cannot ship the steel industry or steel factory with the spacecraft for sure, but we can ship this. The battery is so lightweight. It's come from the spacecraft industry. It's come from the airplane industry, okay? It's just moved to civil engineering stuff. And then the company used that manual for 20 something year already. Okay. Anyway, that is the long column. For the short column, failed by material. This is for the gray cast iron. The gray cast iron has the crack here. Aluminum also have the crack here. If you compress the concrete going to have some kind of crack here. That's called the material failure. This is the example of the water tank, okay? When you do the sanitary water, you treat the water from the tap water. Tap water may have some bacteria, those kind of thing. You kill the bacteria by some chemical. You do the sedimentation, and then your water is clean. You push it to the top. Why? When you distribute the water, the gravity will provide the pressure to the water, and it can deliver to a far away area, right? The column supposed to be very tall, okay, very tall. And then what we have is this kind of tall, long column, maybe prone to, okay, susceptible to buckling. By doing that, we got to do the bracing. If we do this kind of bracing, we have this one is one curve. This one going to be second curve. This one going to be third curve. This one going to be the fourth curve. So by doing this, P critical OE going to be determined by this one, by this one is 4 squared. The column going to be going to have 16 times of the strength of the simple column. Okay, by doing this. Okay, that is for the basing. We will be talking about that later. The buckling is some kind of stability failure. When you push it, curve. When you release the force, go back. That means the behavior of the material under the buckling is in linear elastic behavior. Okay, we are mainly talking about the steel. Okay, we're not talking about the reinforced concrete yet. Until you go to the reinforced concrete design, you will talking about the RC column. So mainly we are talking about steel. Or if you go further in the design, you may talking about the steel. Oh, sorry, aluminum. Okay, that's called the isotropic and homogeneous material. Homogeneous, that means every point on the material have the same material. Steel, you put every point on the steel, they're steel. Okay, and then the column is perfectly straight and long column, and it's supported by pin and roller. Okay, the force applied to the point that's passing the centroid of the section. That means the stress inside the column is compressive stress. And then the buckling occurs only one plane, like this one. Okay. And then we come into the section. Guys, see this? Why is buckling like this? Is one buckling like this? Okay. The buckling can be about this is x axis. Okay. This is y axis. And you can see this is x axis, right? And the y axis point to you. The y axis point to you. And you can see this kind of buckling is the buckling about y axis. Okay. This is y axis. This is y axis. This is. Whoa. Okay. It's curved about y axis. Is the buckling. And then the equation is going to be pi square EI over L square. Let's put it into the simple column. And then I'm going to ask, I'll explain to you about this. The I can be, if you push it over here, I can be, this is going to be, for example, 1 millimeter. And this is going to be 10 millimeter. If I draw thing like this, I'm going to have this one in the axis of what? This is going to be axis of what? Axis that cut the depth. Okay. This is going to be the B axis, right? And then I also have this one if I draw the line here. This is going to be the AA axis. Again, this is AA, right? This AA or Y axis, what I'm said. And then the buckling is like this. So the buckling is going to be allowed, okay, I'll give you an AA axis. And then if you see this, the column, if you compute by this, this is going to be equal. E is going to be equal, the same material. This is the same plastic, okay? And also the L is equal. What the difference is? The I sub A, okay? Or the I sub B. And you compute. If you compute this by I sub B, it's going to be I sub B 1 and 10 cube divided by 12. This is going to be 1000 divided by 12 millimeter powerful. Okay. If again, if you do this by the AA, you will have the I sub A equal to I sub A. I sub A is going to have this one is going to be 10 and then 1 cube divided by 12. This is going to be 10 by 12 millimeter powerful. You can see that this one is a lot larger than I sub A. Okay. So if you put into this equation, this will provide about 100 times larger than this one. Okay. Let's say this may be 100 newton. And this one maybe just one newton okay when you put thing the force will start by zero point five one buckling already it won't go to ten okay so all the buckling will be controlled by the I that is minimum okay to this the I must be controlled by the lowest or the minimum I and then there is example show here okay you can see the I sub x is 66 okay the I sub x is here I about the x is this and I about the y is this is smaller when you put into the equation the I sub y will produce smaller critical load okay so this is going to be your answer of critical load the minimum and then the column still have other sections such as I section such as circular section such as square section thing are different these two section has what so called the double symmetry this I sub a is equal to I sub b so no matter you use in any axis the p critical be equal okay but when you come to the rectangular and the I section okay p critical going to compute basis up on I sub b why because I sub b less than I sub a okay that is the conclusion from what we have and then we determine the critical stress by divide the critical load by the area okay we do the same thing that I mentioned we have this one as the radius of gyration okay this is the property of the section this is the property of the section and then this one can be right you finish again God bless you anyway this is the property of the section this is the length when you divide it it's going to be the L over R we call this one slenderness ratio thinking about Ajahn Siddhichai and his friend okay the same size but one is taller one is shorter okay that is going to be the same ratio it's going to be very important at the end of this before we end of the lecture is going to be the factor that control the critical stress and is control the critical load and to be here we just taking the consideration if for a given material sigma critical proportion to the L over R square okay this ratio and square so for the steel column if you push the result of that calculation into the graph you will get the curve like this and if L over R is small the value of this going to be approach the infinity again that is impossible because the strength of the material controlled by this is steel right is controlled by sigma sub y and again we separate the column into the short and the long column and the point here is the point that we separate the short column from the long column and what we have is at this point sigma critical is equal to sigma sub y so this is going to be pi square e divided by l over r square okay if you put it like this l over r square put it up is going to be pi square e divided by yielding stress. Okay, and then if you go further, you will get this. That divided, and then you put the property of the steel into this equation, and then you get the critical stiffness ratio that separate the short column and the long column to be 88.86, and you can estimate it to be 89. Okay, and you may also determine the critical length of this column. Once in the blue moon, Ajahn will ask you about the critical length, but not often. Okay, just know that the critical length you can be computed by this. And then coming into the column with basing, if there is no basing, the n equal to 1. Okay, this is measure the curve. When you measure the curve, we put this one as the roller. The roller have moment equal to 0. And this is the pin. The pin also have moment equal to 0. We define this one as the one curve. Okay, so this is can be 1. And then when we push it into the middle, the curve can be count as 2. Okay, this is going to be one curve. And you also has this one to be another curve, then your critical load gonna be 4 times larger. Okay, checking the experimental thing, this is the work in Taiwan, a professor working on the strength of the column that is for supporting the formwork. We use a lot of formwork in construction. Okay, the formwork must be basis. Most of the time, the basis is only at the middle like this. Okay, if the basing is only at the middle, he did some testing. He found that by putting the basing like this, it's not enough. Okay, it's not enough. The load is only 320 kilonewton. He put more, not only the basing, over here, he also putting the basing in this direction and in this direction. And you can see this is double from the previous one. Just put two small pieces, okay? Just put two small pieces of lot at one point. You double the capacity of your formwork, okay? So when you go to build high-rise building in Bangkok in your country, okay, and then you put the formwork before you pour the concrete on the top, okay, do a good bracing into your formwork. That's going to enhance the capacity of the supporting system. And then coming into our point, okay, we start our computing. The first one, just thinking about, we have the I section with 3 meters. Guys, in the examination room, you just imagine this is the web, okay? And you imagine the flank, okay? Just imagine the flank. You cannot do the model in your home and bring the model into the lab. They are not allow you, but you may put two or three of them. So this is the flank, okay? Okay, this flank. If this is the flank, again, there is an axis that is pointing to your guys here. This is still the y-axis, okay? And this is still the x-axis. By doing that, if you can do the 3D sketching, okay? Is going to help you into do the computation of this. It's not that beautiful, but I believe it's going to give you some idea what will you do in your room. Okay, by doing something like this, this is going to be the flank. This is going to blank. Okay. Oh, no. Sorry. I just put this one wrong direction. This is going to be a blank. This is going to blank. Okay. And this is going to be the web. This is going to be the web. Okay. This is going to be the web. Okay. If this one going to web, the axis that cross the web, the axis that cross the web is the x axis. So this is going to be x axis. Okay, guys, you see this, right? And the axis that is along the web is called the y axis. So this is going to be the y axis. This is going to be the y axis. Again, you guys can see this is the y axis. Okay, and I sub y is less than I sub x. Why? Just come over here. I sub y is 16 10 power 6 and I sub x is 47.2. okay. The buckling will control by the smaller I. So the buckling is going to be allow I sub Y. Okay. And then you take your image flank out. When you do the compression, this one going to compress like this. Okay. By doing that, what we have, the column will buckle the same like this one. Okay, this is going to be the buckle of this thing. If I going to do it in a complete drawing, this is going to be the curve like this one. And you may go back to the picture that I took out from a paper. It's going to be something like this. And this is going to be something like this, and things are going to be very complicated, right? So I won't recommend you to draw everything. If you draw thing only this, that guide you already. Guide you what? Guide you that this web, this blue web, when it's buckling about green axis, okay? And it's curved like this. And what we have is we are going to use the I sub Y in our computation. Okay, anyway, this thing, let's change this one to be the roller, supposed to be roller and pin. And the application of the first, okay, is going to be buckle about Y axis, since it has the smaller I, okay. You put thing into your equation, pi square e I divided by L square. You get this one for 3,509 kilonewton. That's really large, okay. That's about 3.5 million newton, okay. And then when you get this one, the important thing about the buckling is what? The stress critical must less than yielding stress. Okay, so you got to determine the sigma critical. You divide 3,509 kilonewton by the given area. Okay, you have this one for 552, which is larger than this one. So this one is the short column. This computation cannot use. It's not a long column, it's a short column. So you got to determine the load by putting sigma sub y into your calculation. And this column can take the maximum load of 1,590.5 kilonewton. Okay, this is short column, failed by yielding. Ajahn, 3 meters is not short column. It's short column by the equation. Okay. It's short column because it's failed by yielding. Okay. Ajahn, it's supposed to be just only 1 meter. No, it depends on the size. Okay. If the column is very small like this, okay. If this small like this and it's 1 meter, okay, it's bucking. But if the column is really big like this and it's 1 meter, no, it's one. Okay. So the effect of the section also play the important rule of this. We will consider next. We extend the column into 6 meter. We do the same thing. The buckling will be around the y axis. Since I sub y is smaller than I sub x, we put thing into the equation. Just change 3 square into 6 square. We got this one for 877.3. Why? Before that is divided by 3 square is 9. This is divided by 36. Okay. Large, a lot larger. And then the stress is less than sigma sub y. This column starts to be the long column. And then the curve is going to be curved out, right? It's about what we used to have the form the previous one is going to buckle like this. This buckle like this is mean what? It mean your light blue web. This is light blue web. If you draw the picture in three dimension, it's going to change from the light blue to the black. That I said, don't worry. Just put it in the web. Just put thing in the web. This is the web, okay? The light blue change to the black, okay? Don't worry about the flank. The flank will follow the web. Ah, okay, if you follow that, the bucking is going to be like that. One important thing, if you're going to see this back thing, we're going to look at this direction. You're going to take a look at this direction. You're going to take a look at this direction, okay? That means if it's the bucking about y-axis, you got to take a look along y-axis and you will see the buckle shape in the y-axis. Okay, it's going to be that point. This thing again. This is y-axis, okay? And if you take a look along y-axis, you will see the buckle shape, right? You will see the buckle shape. If you take a look at this one, you will not see the buckle shape. You will see something like the same. Okay. That is very important point. Okay. Longer column. Change the column from the short to the long column. Okay. Summary. If you compute and you find critical stress less than yield stress, that column going to be the long column. The last example, okay? And then that's failed by the buckling, okay? And if you got the critical stress equal to sigma sub y, that column is short, okay? Yeah, sigma going to be this P sub Y. P sub Y gonna be sigma sub Y times A. Okay, just pick like this. And coming next, start going to be getting more complicated. At this point, you will have the I section in your examination. You will not have this kind of rectangular, okay? You will have the I section because in your real experience, real work, the steel column mostly always have the I section. If not I section, it's going to have the box section. Okay, and I section use a lot. That example will provide you with the I section. The I section will assume by using the rectangular section. Just imagine the flank. Okay? You use your imagine. If not, bring another with the tape. They cannot
said you cannot use the tape and this one you can use okay and view your eye section and take a look at it but you got to do quick okay and then anyway again it's always rotate along the axis that you take a look along it okay it won't be x if you look at x you will see this side if you use this y you will see the curve the support can be many things, okay? And as I mentioned before, our senior engineer modified the support by putting the K, okay, into the question. By starting the point, our Professor Euler said, by considering the simple column, we get this equation. By putting the force into this column again, this one have one curve. And Professor coming into another problem. We have the fix as I show you the picture. And then again, you put the compression into it. This one will deform like this, deform like this, and the curve gonna be small, like at the middle, see? Only at the middle, at the curve. And he said, this is going to be 0.5L. For this fix, for this fix, okay? The K is 0.5. You got to remember this. You got to remember this equation. You got to remember the K. And you got to remember sigma critical equal to pi square E divided by KL over R square. Just put the K, okay, later. And then Professor Euler also consider the other thing, the column that is roller here and fixed here. Let's call this is a roller, this is fixed. Under the compression, the shape of this one just in combination of the green and the red, in the combination, that is going to have this kind of green, okay? No, sorry, this have red, okay, red. And then coming into this portion is going to be have the shape as the green one, okay? And he said this one going to have the length of 0.7L, okay? And the last one, he talking about the flagpole, okay? Under the application of the force, the flagpole will have the shape like this. And you got to connect the flagpole with the imaging portion. And the L of this is going to be 2L. So we introduce the K factor. The K factor is called effective length factor. Okay, when it's time into the L, we call the KL is just the effective length. Okay, KL is effective length. And the K, just put the factor into it. So you get this one. And then when you push them into this factor, KL over R is going to be effective slimness ratio. Okay, this is going to be one, the K1. This is going to be two. This is going to be 0.5. This is going to be 0.7. Do the test. This is going to be one. This is going to be 0.5 because the length just put into this. Okay. The curve is just in this portion. And this one, the curve just be in this portion. This one is going to be 0.7. This one is 0.5. However, this one, you got to push it into the second. It's going to be curve out like this. Okay, that is going to be 2.0. So this is 1.0, 0.5, 0.7. And this one is 2.0. Okay, we come to the portion that we are going to
be very close to the problem in our examination. Let me start for a simple one again by the rectangular one. This portion is kind of the machine. This kind of machine is going to have something like this. It have the rivet, okay, putting like this. By putting like this, if you push it, there is two way. There's two way. If this one going to rotate into you, this is going to be pin. And put this one into the pin. Putting one into pin. Okay. If this one is in this direction, this one is Y, per se. This is in the Y direction. Let me put this one to you. Okay. This one is the Y direction. Okay. I think this is 15 millimeter and this is 40 millimeter. This one going to be pin. Actually, I got to put the hole like this. Okay. And if it like this, it's going to be pin. In the other way, in this direction, it's going to be fixed. Okay, fixed. This one is pin. Putting into you. Actually, you don't see it. You don't see it. This is in Y direction. Follow the picture here. Okay. And this is X direction. What you see is in the buckling in the X. What you see is buckling in the X. Right? Or buckling in the Y. When you take a look in the Y, like this, you have the buckling about Y. See my pen. Okay, see my pen. This is buckling about Y. Okay, and you cannot see this one. Buckling about Y is going to be this one. This is buckling about Y. Because of what? Because this is the Y axis. You take a look into Y axis. You take a look in the Y axis. See, you have this one, right? The K is 0.5. And then the other one is going to be pin like this, out like this. I cannot show you by using this. I only use the imaging to show you. One is going to be about YY. Why Ajahn said that since this is a YY axis, you take a look along YY axis. This is the buckle about YY. Buckle about X. You got to see like this. It's going to come out there to be pin. Okay? It's going to be pin like this. This is going to be your problem, but the section going to be I section. Again, don't worry. Let me draw you like this. Let me draw you guys like this. We have this one. Okay, you made all 3D. And what you have is this one going to have the pin here. Okay. The rivet. Let's call the rivet or the head of the bow, something like this. So by doing this, this is going to be the X axis. X. Okay, along this X axis. And this is going to be the Y axis, okay? When its whole Y axis is have this portion to hold it, okay? So for the Y axis, you will see the shape of this to be this one. You take a look along the Y axis, okay? You take a look along the y-axis. And then again, you have this. You have this again. And then you do the drawing of this. Now, your rivet is here, okay? And the axis that you are interested is along this one. This is going to be the x, okay? The x can be curve like this. See, it's different. But I cannot show by the demonstration by this one. I can show by this one. And then the K of this one is 1.0 and K of this one is 0.5. This is K sub Y. This is K sub X. Okay. Again. Again.
Fix, fix. Okay. Along Y axis. The pen is Y axis. Fix, fix. Okay. Another way. This one, Y. This is 6X. Okay, X. You got to take a look at this one. And this is in use your imagination. You cannot do the experimental for everything. One, you can see it. Another one, imagine it.
And then what you have is this one. Just put them together. The A, the I. The I sub X is larger than I sub Y because this is 15 millimeter. This is going to be 40 millimeter. I sub X is 15 times 40 cube. I sub Y is about let this one going to be 40 times 15 cube. Okay, I sub X always larger than I sub Y. And then what we have is putting them together. But to compute here, I suppose to know that there is two methods to show you. The first one is no good. I will show you. The second one is more general. And most of the time we use the second one. The first one, we start by critical load. Okay, critical load. The second one, we start by the slenderness ratio. Okay, by use the first method, just put everything together. Okay, it's very straightforward. This is for the critical about X. This is going to be K equal to 1.0. And then you push it again into the Y, this is K sub Y equal to 0.5, and then you get this. Which one going to be your answer? The lower one, okay? This is going to be your answer, okay? You are kind of blind, just putting. You didn't select, okay? And you select at the end of that. And then there is a lot of computation here. And then you put it into the stress. The stress is going to be less than this one. This is going to be linear, elastic. It's going to be okay. And then your answer is going to be 259 kilonewton. And the allowable going to be divided by factor of safety. It's going to be 148.03. Okay, this is the first method. The second method, we didn't start by checking the stress. Actually, we start by checking the slenderness ratio because larger slenderness ratio will produce smaller critical stress. And that is going to govern, control our calculation. The lower one going to be control our calculation. Okay. By doing this, again, we determine the thing. By the concept of maximum effective slenderness ratio, will provide the lower sigma critical. And then we do the computation of R sub X. Okay, we have this one. R sub Y, we have this one. We don't know yet. Until we put them together. For this one, we have K sub X. We have K sub X. K sub XL over R sub X. And we have K sub Y, L over R sub Y. And then we select which one going to be the control of this. The larger one, because the larger one will provide the, this is K sub X is 1. The L is 600 divided by R sub X. We got 52. The second one, thank you. Oh, which one going to control? Okay, the large one, not small one. Sorry, the large one. Okay, the large one control the design of this. Sorry, the large one. I'm confused. It's going to produce smaller sigma. Okay, smaller sigma. And then you got this one again, less than sigma sub y. And then the sigma critical is just sigma critical time A. And then allowable, you divide sigma critical by, you divide P critical by factor of safety. And then you get the P allow. Okay, let us use the second method. And then if I prefer the first one, it's up to you. But for only one method, it's complicated enough already. And then we start by what? We start by the concept of this equation, sigma critical proportion to L over R square. Okay, K actually, KLR square. So we start by taking the calculation for the R, okay? After the R, and then we will going to the K, okay? The green. And the light blue. And then if you go further, we go to calculate the KLOR. So we start by the green and then go to the blue and then go to the yellow. Okay, we have this one. Don't worry, I sub X and A for the I section, Ajahn will give you. Ajahn won't ask you to determine I sub X or I sub Y because Ajahn think you already know very clearly to compute the I from the ending static, okay? And the real world, you open the steel table, okay? I sub X and I sub Y can be determined easily. And then you determine the K. One important thing is you got to take a look clearly which way going to be the K sub X, which way going to be K sub Y. K sub Y just look along Y axis. K sub X just look along X axis, okay? And then the buckle about X axis can be seen by looking toward XX and the Y axis looking toward YY. And then you compute this one for the yellow. Which one going to be the control? The smaller or the larger? Again, go back. The larger will control the sigma critical. You select the largest because in some problem, it's not two. In some problem, you will see can be three. So we use the largest sometimes. And then when you use the maximum, you put it into the divider, okay? So you get the smaller sigma critical. And then check if sigma critical is less than sigma sub y, is okay, it's going to be the buckle. If not, you can have it only sigma sub y. For example, if you have sigma critical to be 200 megapascal, that is less than sigma sub y, okay? Your sigma max is 200 megapascal. If anyway you do the computation, you have sigma critical to be 300 megapascal, you cannot use this one. You can use only sigma max equal to 250 megapascal. This is for the short column. Okay. And then you find the P max equal to sigma max A. That's really simple. And then you also can find the P allow by divide the P max by factor of safety. Coming into this. The problem is this one. I trying to do the graphic for you guys to see it. And again, if you take a look along X axis, what is going to be take a look along X axis? You will see this. When you take a look along X axis, you will see this. You will see the wave.
Okay, let me put it into this way. If you put it into, if you take a look along this one, you will see the light blue. The light blue is going to be along the web. See? Along the web. You see the light blue? Right? You see the light blue? And if you take a look along the Y is here. Along the Y here. Okay. The Y is not like this. The flank is going to be take a look this way. When you take a look this way, you will see this. Ajahn, why things are different like this? Because we put the basing into this direction. Okay. The basing here didn't produce anything, but the basing here will produce again. This is what the basing produces. Okay. And I only show you in the other way. If, for example, we also have the cable of the basing. Okay. If anything is happening, please, come here. And any guy, girl or guy, it's okay. See, this guy, just hold this one. This is. If this is y-axis, okay, this can be moved, okay, and then go back. And just hold your hand really quick. And if you like to move this way, I cannot. Same thing as the basing. Basing can rest only in this direction, along its direction. It cannot rest in the perpendicular direction, okay? That's why in this one, the green basing cannot do the basing, okay? Only in this one, the basing do the basing. It cannot do this one. You hold that one, okay? This one can be like this, okay? But this one cannot do like this. See, very easy here. Okay, but very tough in this direction. This is the concept of bracing.
Okay, this is the concept of bracing. Just take this one. That's kind of a lot of things like, that's why you're going to produce your engine sense. This thing going to produce your engine sense by using your imagination. Okay, let's us do the problem. Again, guys coming into this. This section is W150. Let me mention most of the problem can come into three dimension. And in many problem come in two dimension. Let me start from the three dimension first, okay? And by doing this, we will have the pin support at top and the bottom, okay? And the bracing is in this direction. That means what? It can move this way easily, but it cannot move in this direction. Okay, that's I show you, right? Okay, from the equation that we have, sigma critical equal to pi square e divided by kl over r. So we start by taking a look at the light blue portion, and we will start by the computation of the R first. The R sub X equal to I sub X divided by A. Okay, that is very simple. R sub X is equal to I sub X divided by A. And then you got this, and then later, you go to this one, this R sub Y equal to I sub Y divided by A. Just divide it. Ajahn will give it to you. Do it carefully. If you put this one correctly, you may get one score already. Okay. And next, go to the K. Okay. K is another 2 point. Another 2 point. And then you come here. Depend on you look. If you look along X axis, okay. And then when you look along X axis, you will see the web. See? You will see the web. You will see the web. And then it can be moved like this. So by doing that, this web axis will deform something going to be like this. This is going to be your web. Okay. And again, you see this one, right? You see this one, right? Let me erase this. Let me erase this. This is going to be another way. If you again, you take a look in this direction. You take a look in this direction. What you find? You find the flank. You find this flank. Okay. And then this is pin. The bracing always provide the pin. Okay. So when you see this one, you will have the deformation of this one. Okay. This is going to be your left flank. And then going to be this one. This is your red. This K is 1.0, K sub Y top, and K sub Y bottom going to be 1.0. Okay, by doing this, let me put it like this. Okay, again. This is what you have for the web. Okay, this is what you have for the web. When you take a look at it, you get the light blue web, and you also get the section bracing, I section here, okay? And this is going to be pin. The buckling along with what direction? Along with the X, see? This is the X axis buckling, okay? Now, again. Let me put it another way. Let me take a look in this direction. Okay, if I take a look in this direction, I get this one for the flank. So I get this one for the flank. I get this one for the flank. And I also has the bracing. Oh, sorry. I also have the bracing. Along this one and along this one, this is the green bracing as the middle, okay? See, and then this is pin, and this also pin. You have another one here, so whatever you like, you may take a look thing like this, or may you go back take a look thing this way. That I do for you. It's up to you. Okay, that is two ways. One, draw it in three dimension. Another one, draw it in two dimension. And then you get this one. All of the K is 1.0. And then KL R sub X, like this. And since this one is going to be 4 meter, and this one going to be 4 meter, the KL of the top and the bottom equal, okay, and divided by R sub Y, you get this one. This is the control. You get 163 as the control. Just use 163.6 divided. You get this one less than sigma sub Y. Thing is okay, and then you can determine the pre-critical by time sigma critical by A. You get this one as the critical load. You cannot use it. You divide it by factor of safety. If the factor of safety to be 2.0, you will get the P allowed of 225.7 divided by 2.0 kilonewton. Okay, Ajahn may ask you for the he allow okay one way another way อาจารย์ didn't ask you for the he allow he said the building now has the load of 200 kilonewton now
the column
there get the 200 kilonewton what the factor of safety
so the final question can be two ways one given the factor of safety ask you to find the he allow the author give you the actual p ask you to determine the factor of safety yeah just change it okay and then you get the factor of safety of 1.128 this is larger than 1 is okay larger than 1 okay we have a lot of problem again in conclusion we start by r and then we go to the k and then we find the kl over r we use the max right we use the max phi r phi k put the k and r put the k and r use the maximum and then put them into your equation put the maximum into your equation and then you check it with the sigma sub y if it's less than sigma sub y is okay if not use sigma sub y okay and the last one p max equal to sigma max time a okay and then they are may ask you to find the p allow if this one is given okay or they may ask you to find factor of safety if they give you the p x okay p x on the structure now okay the same problem many years like that they pick thing in the problem just change thing this one take the support to be fixed and fix the problem just change to fix the section still the same okay the r is going to be the same the r sub x equal to I sub x divided by a r sub y equal to I sub y divided by a okay it's going to be the same and what happened is the k the k going to be the problem again taking a look I will take a look in this direction what is this direction in the x and then I find what I find the web right I find the web and then what by finding the web the basing like this one can move right it cannot move in along its axis it can move like this since it's moved like this Ajahn can say this one going to be fixed this one going to be something like this okay and if you prefer just put the web the dimension of the web to make it like the web okay and then we take a look in another direction let me take a look along y axis this one I will find my flank okay I will find my flank by this way what I have is this one is fixed and this one going to be the pin okay this one going to be fixed pin this one is going to be k sub y top equal to 0.7 this one going to be k sub x is going to be 0.5 you are very good very well very quick understanding and then at the bottom is going to be mess up thing a little bit I put it in red and the k here going to k sub y bottom and this one going to be 0.7 okay again if you do in two dimension if you guys do in two dimension take a look in the x direction you get this one for the web and you also has this section of the eye okay you take a look at this one you just get the eye and this one going to be your
light blue, and this one your light blue show you the web. Top is fixed, bottom is fixed. This one gonna be the rotation. Let me put this way of this one, and this one, and you have this one like this. Okay, the case of x is 0.5. Now you come into this direction. Now you take a look in this direction. You see your flank. Okay, you see your flank. And then you also see you blessing. See you blessing. See you blessing like this. Okay. The blessing is pin. So you have this one for what? For fix, and then have this one to be this one. Make it larger, okay? And then this is going to be K sub Y top 0.7. And this one also, this one going to be K sub Y bottom 0.7. They are equal, right? So you just compute only one of them. And then this one control, and you can see by changing the pin into the fix. Before this one of 160 something, this one reduced to 114. It's going to be produced larger sigma critical. Okay, and then this column can take larger loading. See, previous one get about 200 something, this one 400 something. By fix the column top and bottom, and then compare to the yielding. Yielding is larger. Okay, the load start from 0, 100, 200, 300, 400, and then reach this buckling. It cannot go to this large. Okay, let's see. The factor of safety, again, they can ask you for PLR. They also can marking you for the factor of safety. But for the factor of safety, this one will give when, okay, the actual force. And then let's see this one. We change this one into two dimension. Ajahn will provide you two dimension or three dimension. Don't worry. By doing this, you can do the same sketching, okay? You will have this one for the flank, and this one for the web, and this one for the flank, and the section gonna be something like this if you prefer 2D. But most of the time, my student didn't prefer 2D, they just prefer 3D. And then what we have is this one is the basing. See, the basing is going to be something like this. And if you dot it, it's going to dot it in this way. And then it's going to be in this way. Okay. And the top is pin. Okay. And your axis, again, your axis, when the axis cut this one, this is going to be X direction. This one along XX. I didn't do a good drawing. Oh, sorry, it's going to be fixed. Thank you. Okay. And this one is X. Okay. Sorry. This one going to be this one along the X. Right? This one along X. And then you take a look at the X direction. You see what? You see the light blue here. You see the light blue here. You see the light blue here. You take a look along this X direction. And then you see the light blue here, okay? This is along the X direction. And then what we have is, this is pin, this is fixed. As your friend told me, this is gonna rotate this one and then come back to fix. This one can move in this perpendicular direction, okay? Okay, and another picture, let me draw it very close to here. I cannot put it over there. It's going to be very messed up. Okay, let me put it in another column. Okay, by putting this column, we going to what? Going to consider in the y direction. Okay. Let Ajahn put this thing into this direction, into this direction, into this into this y direction, into this y direction. That means Ajahn will see the flank. Okay. That means Ajahn will see the flank. Okay. Ajahn will see the flank, right? Ajahn will see the flank. And Ajahn also can see the blessing, because I take a look to see the flank. So I see my blessing here. Okay, blessing here. Blessing is hit the flank. Hit the web. And then what we have is this one is going to be pin. This one is pin. So the top is going to be pin. That's K sub Y top gonna be 1.0. And K sub Y top time L. L is 4 meter. That is 4. On the bottom, I get this one for pin and fix. And then I get this one for the curve like this. And the K sub Y bottom gonna be 0.7. Thank you very much. Very good, girl. And then this one gonna time 6, okay? And then it won't be equal. We got to compare the top and the bottom. Two previous problem, we get equal. K sub Y top and K sub Y bottom. But this one, this is the hardest problem that you can find. And just guess, Ajahn going to do what? Pin, fix. Pin, or fix pin. There is another problem of this is fix pin. Okay, you do the same thing, and then you do the same thing. R sub x, R sub y. Then the k is going to be like this for k sub x. As I draw you can see this one and this one, this black one, the same, right? And then you will get the order. This one is pin one, and this one is pin fix, and the k are different. So this guy control the computation. So we get this one and do the same thing, do the computation the same thing, on the bottom the same thing. The main thing is finding the k. Okay, the k. But before find the k, get the r sub x and r sub y for 1 point. The k gonna provide 2 or 3 like this. K going to be 3 points, each of them going to be 1 point. And then we going to determine the same thing. And the last one, this one gonna be fixed, okay, as the bottom. And like your friend and me do, so we just tie this one, okay, it cannot move in this direction. It cannot move in the x direction this way, but it can move in the y direction. By doing this, Ajahn, let's say in this direction, it can move, okay? By moving in that direction, you take a look again along x axis. You see your light blue web, okay? Your light blue web gonna be something that's going to be like this. That is going to be free and fixed. This is K looking along X. K sub X is going to be 2.0. Okay, 2.0. And then again, you take a look. It's very, very fun to do so. You take a look in this direction. You see what? You see your flank. And now, can you move in this direction? No, you cannot move in this direction, okay? You take a look in this direction, you take a look in Y, okay? So this one gonna have some shape, something like this. So your K sub Y gonna be 0.7, okay? It's very fun to do so. A lot of drawing, okay? When I was young, The first thing that Ajahn always told, draw a lot. When you draw things, you understand things. If you can recreate the picture, that means you start to understand the picture. When you start understand the picture, you're going to start understand the problem. For me, I never really can think. Like when you're Hang Samma, Samutho, Pakawa, I didn't do that, okay? I always remember the picture. And I explain my own picture on my word. That means you don't need your memory much, okay? You use your understanding. And then you can produce your understanding very quick. So start by taking for the arm very easy, right? Okay, and then K. But again, for someone that's not yet understanding, you have this one for the light blue for the web. Okay, and the web is going to be showing you here. Okay, and then you also can move along this direction as I show you. That means you can move in this direction. So this one is K point 2.0. And then you have the K times L divided by R sub X. And then another way you take a look at your flank in the Y direction. You take a look in this direction. You take a look in this direction. This is fixed. And this cannot move, right? Cannot move. The shape gonna be something like this. You get this one for 0.7. And then which one going to control? K sub Rx. And if you notice from the last four problem, this is the problem that's K sub X control sigma sub critical. Before that, if you notice, always K sub Y. Okay, always K sub Y. Okay, this one, only K sub X. And then what we have is this one. Just do the same thing. Everything just like this. Okay, I think you guys can go back and try to recreate what I lecture you today. And this problem, please get 10 score. Okay, and next lecture, I will come again by reviewing the problem number one, number two, number three, number four. If I have time, again, we come to number five. If not, whatsoever we have. And I post the PowerPoint for the next lecture already on the Facebook. Just go through it. And come to the class and see Ajahn and you, we think in the same direction or not. Okay, if we think in the same direction, I think that is the successful of our study. Okay, so see you next Thursday for the last class. Okay, prepare yourself. Okay, good luck. Bye-bye. Have a nice day. Yes.